So far in this video series, we've talked a lot about what causes stress and the effects that stress can have on you and your family. So in this video, I want to talk through 5 ways to reduce stress in your life. And of course, we've all been in stressful situations, both good and bad, every day. But when you put the plan of action that I'm going to talk about in this video into place, you'll find you'll be able to reduce your stress quite considerably. Okay, the first thing that you want to do is identify what's making you stressed in the first place. Is there something that you can do differently to avoid the stress? Can you eliminate it? And if you can't eliminate it, can you manage it? And a good way to find out what's making you stressed is to keep a stress journal. Every time you find yourself in a stressful situation, you want to make a note of it. And if these things keep cropping up on a regular basis, then you're going to notice a pattern, and then you can think about how you're going to deal with it. Because once you've identified a problem, you're halfway to finding a solution. Another way to reduce stress is to get physical. Bear in mind that we're dealing with the fight or flight response that our bodies have. So we're going to have all this extra energy, all this extra adrenaline. So one way to get rid of it is to get physical. So take your dog for a walk if you have a dog. Walk, cycle, or take public transport rather than drive your car. Use the stairs at work or the mall rather than an elevator or an escalator. And you can park your car in the farthest spot in the parking lot and then walk the rest of the way. All of this is going to burn up this energy that your body is creating for the fight or flight response. You're going to be burning it up in a good way rather than internalizing it and causing stress. Then you want to eliminate the unnecessary so that you're not having all sorts of different stimuli coming at you from all sorts of different directions, and you're not having all sorts of different demands made on your time. So you want to cut down on your commitments. If you find that there aren't simply enough hours in the day to do everything comfortably, you want to decide what's important and keep them, and you want to decide what's not important and drop it. And you want to unsubscribe from email lists. You want to make sure that you avoid distractions, and lots of different email lists can be very distracting. So if you find that you're not really reading someone's emails, or you're finding that they're taking up too much time and they're taking time away from things that are more important, then unsubscribe from that email list and get rid of that distraction. You can also combine lots of short journeys or lots of errands into one longer task. So if you need to go to the bank and you need to go to the supermarket and you need to go to the post office, instead of doing 3 separate journeys, do it all in one go and get it all over with in one go. And then you're reducing the amount of stress because, you know, the fact that you're having one large amount of stress is actually sometimes better for you than lots of little amounts of stress on an ongoing basis. So the fact that you're sort of getting it all over and done with in one go can help to eliminate a lot of stress. The other thing is to avoid people you find stressful. I know in some situations this is easier said than done. If you've got a very difficult person that you have to deal with on a day-to-day basis, if it's your boss, well, you're probably not going to be able to avoid him or her. But if it's somebody else that you're finding very stressful, you can simply cut them out, or you can communicate with them via email rather than face-to-face, especially if you always end up arguing with them. Then that's a good way to avoid getting into conflict, because, you know, it's hard to start an argument via email because you have to put some thought into it. You're not going to sort of fly off the handle. So that's a good way of doing it. But avoiding people that you find stressful can cut down on your stress considerably. And finally, simplify your life. look at things that are unnecessary, look at things that you can really do without, and do without them. Because if they're making you stressed, then they really are serving no useful purpose whatsoever. You should also eat healthily, because you want to make sure that your body is getting enough nutrition, because that can help cut down on stress. So eliminate junk food is the first thing to do. Eat proper, regular meals whenever you possibly can, because having a balanced diet, making sure that your body gets a balanced diet, a balanced intake of vitamins and the right amount of nutrients can help to cut down on stress, and it can help your body to deal with stress in a more efficient way. So you should also cut down on sugar and caffeine, because they're both stimulants, and when you are trying to reduce stress, you don't want stimulants. You want to keep things as calm as possible. And you should also avoid alcohol, cigarettes, and drugs. Although they can have a temporary effect in calming you down, the problem is, of course, you then open up another whole can of worms, because alcohol, cigarettes, and drugs also have their own inbuilt health problems. So you might be trading one problem, stress, for another problem that's related to alcohol, cigarettes, or drugs. And finally, you want to think positive. You know, eliminating negative thoughts does help to reduce stress. If you, like the old song says, always look on the bright side of life. If you look for the positive in situations, then that's going to cut down on the stress, because you're not going to be having this constant negativity hammering at you all the time, which can be very, very stressful. And of course, it helps to develop a good sense of humor. See the funny side in every situation, and that can help to reduce the stress, because it helps to reduce the fear. And fear is a big motivator, a big part of the fight or flight response. In this final video of the series, I'll bring everything together and recap on what we've covered so far. We've covered quite a lot of ground in this video series. So let's just recap what we've covered so that we can put everything into perspective. First of all, stress is a reaction to the fight or flight mechanism that's hardwired into our psyche. And it harks back to your inner caveman or inner cavewoman. And in modern life, we try to suppress this, and it leads to a permanently raised state of alertness, which is better defined as stress. Now, stress can be good or bad. Good stress can be exciting, invigorating, helps you to fulfill your potential, and it can be a learning experience. On the other hand, bad stress can be debilitating, soul-destroying. It can ruin your life, and it's probably the most common form of stress. And bad stress can lead to severe and long-lasting health problems, things like heart attacks, strokes, ulcers, skin conditions, and a lot more. Stress affects many different parts of the body, and it can be harmful to your kids too. Workplace stress might be intrinsic to the job. It could be down to your role in the organization. It can be caused by lack of career development. And it may be symptomatic of your working environment. Now, this could be your physical environment. If you work somewhere very stressful, if you work in a bad neighborhood and you have to walk down a dark alley at nighttime to get to your place of work, then that can be very stressful. It could be down to the psychological environment. You know, if there's lots of office politics and backbiting going on, then you might find it's very stressful to work where you work. Or it could be down to the organizational structure that simply lends itself to being very stressful because it's very poorly organized. If you're an entrepreneur, you might get very stressed over the unpredictability and risk of your lifestyle. There may be problems with finances, especially cash flow. You might find dealing with clients stressful. And likewise, you might find dealing with subcontractors to be stressful as well. You might be suffering from information overload and not know exactly what to do because you have all sorts of different things that you're being bombarded with. Or you might be launching a new product or a new project, and that brings with it lots of different stressful situations. Likewise, difficulty maintaining an adequate work-life balance can be very stressful as well. Setting boundaries can reduce stress. When you learn to say no without feeling guilty, then you reduce your stress burden considerably. And you should give yourself the same priority as you would give to others. You want to make sure that you have some me time in your life so that you're not completely at other people's behest, so that you can be in control of your own destiny, and that reduces stress considerably. And you want to look at what's causing your stress and see if it can be managed or eliminated. As I've said in earlier videos, once you've identified the problem, you're halfway to finding the solution. And you want to stay healthy so that your body can deal with stress adequately. And that means taking proper exercise. That means eating properly. That means avoiding alcohol, tobacco, and drugs. And finally, when all else fails, if you find that you're still having trouble with stress, then you need to seek professional help. Now, this can be making an appointment to see your doctor. It could mean seeing a therapist or a hypnotherapist or someone who can help you deal with the stressful situation that you're under. Remember, your health is very important, so you don't want to sacrifice it because of the stressful situation that you happen to be under. I hope you found this video series useful, and I hope it points you in the right direction to get away from stress. And I wish you every success.